guys, it's Kenzie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys, giving you guys some tips, some little hacks, if you will, for turning on point. But hopefully I do have some good tips to help me. This is what I kind of focus on and what I kind of do to turn. I don't do, like, I'm not a crazy turner, like those turners on Instagram. Like, yeah, so let's just get into the first one. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna explain is the preparation. I know a lot of teachers teach things differently, and honestly, there is a lot of ways to do it, and kind of just depends on what is best for you, but as you go about in your dancing, you'll figure out what works best for you. And this year, I really figured out what was best for me in my turns, since I'm practicing a lot more. But I'm gonna show you what I do. There's a lot of other ways to do it, but I'm just gonna show you the preparation that I do. So obviously starting from fourth, I used to do my fourth like with my back foot really crossed, which is like a true fourth, you know what I mean? For a turn, if you're really crossed, your hips twist. It's just like a really uncomfortable position. What I do is this is what a lot of men do to get a lot of force, and do this. And then go. So I don't do it that big, but I do. I start like my heel is in the middle of like my arch. What I do when I go tendu like that, I keep my back leg straight. Then right when I'm about to go off, I bend and then I go. I would say majority of the weight is on my front foot, but there is definitely some weight on my back foot too. I have this so you can go. I think a wider stance just gives you more force and more stability on your leg. So I'm going to show you the difference. I'm going to do a double turn. And this is how I used to do it. So I used to do it. Yeah. It wasn't bad, but that, okay, I don't know if you guys can see the difference. I feel a difference in that, and I just feel a lot more stable on the other one, and I feel like I could do a lot more turns. And the second thing that I'm gonna tell you guys, this one's like really important. It really changed my turns this year and the way that I approach them. When you're in your preparation and you're beginning to go, a lot of people wind up to go to get their force, but that's not how you want to start your turns. Technically, your turn starts here. So I know a lot of teachers are like, oh, you have to get it like right away, but you're not gonna get any force from that. Like, I learned this in class this year and it really helped me a lot. They actually want to plie and then go. I don't know how else to explain it, but it's just like, okay, obviously you get the idea. Like, I just get a lot more force. See, I'm gonna do it without doing that. I'm gonna try to do it. You might not see a difference, but I'm gonna have a lot less force. So a lot of people, when they're doing their turn, they think that you should go with your arm out in instead of going like that. But you should never open your arm like that because it throws you back and like off balance. So the difference is just like, I don't know, it just doesn't work. So you should always keep your arm in front of you and you're just a lot more stable. You just like go up. I don't know if I'm explaining this good. So that's a really big important part because I literally just learned that this year. It just makes like turns make a lot more sense. The next thing that's really, really important, when I turn, like I'll just kind of lazily like do a turn and I like won't really be thinking about something. I just feel really, like it just doesn't really work that well. It's not as clean or as just like up as I wanted to. Like I'll probably tilt or something. The thing that I always think about is my spot. I never realized how important your spot is for turning, but if something is off balance, your spot can fix it. Like you can still stay up if something's like going off. But your spot is really hard, you can still stay up and save that turn. Like, I'm not even kidding, I do it all the time. If you have really good placement and you know that it's kind of like you have it like that, try focusing on your spot because usually your placement is muscle memory. And then, you know, if you focus on your spot, it'll just keep you like right up. So I'm gonna do one without focusing on my spot. Somehow I'm gonna do it. Like it just doesn't work. It just doesn't feel as crisp and clean as if I were to do like, you know what I mean? The next thing is really important, and I want to shout this across every dance studio in the whole entire world. And the most important thing in ballet, in my opinion, I mean, like, I'm not even a professional, I'm literally 16, but in my personal experience, the most important thing is pulling up. If you pull up, not back, but like up out of your hips and up out of your back, just think of like your spine just like expanding, and then like it goes all the way through your head and up, and your hips, there's like a space like this, and this should be your placement throughout everything that you do in ballet. And I swear to God, like, if you do this throughout class, everything will be 10 times more easier. I think this kind of clicked for me when I went to Joffrey in like 2016. I was in like 7th grade. I don't know. I really focused on that, and like, I improved so much. Adagio in center was so much easier. I could actually stand on my leg. And yeah, so obviously this applies to turns like big time. Because if you're sitting down, first of all, it just doesn't look good, no offense. It just doesn't look very professional, and it just doesn't really work because you're just like sinking, and then, you know, everything just can be loose and you'll just go everywhere. But if you're just really pulling up, but yeah, that is like a really important part. If you just think of pulling up, keeping your spot really sharp, and your passe turned out. Because if your passe is like this, I'm gonna do a turn like that. I'm gonna try to do a turn like that. I just can't even do that. If your passe is like that, you cannot get around. You have to like just open up, because that knee will help you. That knee will help you go around. There's like so many elements to things that just apply to like ballet in general. Your shoulders down. Don't think of lifting up back, but make sure you're lifting up like up, but like a little bit forward. Your spot is your anchor. Like, if you have a good spot, you can usually stay on balance. I'm not gonna say it's gonna work every time. Step over turns. Every time I do them, I have to focus on my spot, otherwise it just will go down the drain. Yeah, I hope this helped you guys a little bit. And these were just some tips and things that I think about when I do my turns. And yeah, if you want more videos like this, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, subscribe. And thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Stay confident. Bye.